is my mama's dog still alive.
Have you think that?
I think so.
He lived down there. Around the past on.
Did he?
He came in and police.
Daddy!
He had a condo in the same place my grandma. Down there in North Carolina. What was that place? What was that place?
Are you filming our meeting here?
Yes, sir.
Well, you'll learn about county basketball,
His daughter's got an injury.
Yeah, her knee's better.
I'm glad to hear that. I'm sorry. She was hurt.
That'll be the big topic for her.
That'll be the most thing you find out from us.
Well, yeah, that one, she's playing that. She plays there.
Jeff, did you get your fair share?
It was better.
Are you playing it at all?
Have you seen him play?
It's good for him.
Time to you, right?
Is Faye's granddaughter getting any better? She's a rough project wife.
Other leg working ball.
We got to make more money. She came when she started in the ninth grade.
They're probably.
And now they're seniors. Can you believe that?
But they're coaching.
Let's go save money, man. I'm dessert. You got an extra check in there tonight?
We got any help up there?
I need to shut this one. For any one of your viewers who's interested, I had to leave Dora the Explorer. My granddaughter was watching it.
Yeah.
I said, I get the wrong, this ain't the county.
You must be around the street.
He didn't get all the players. Oh, we're on film here. Watch out.
About 5 o'clock, yeah. How are you? Hey, guys, hey, Fred.
How are you?
Mr. Williams.
It's been a while, man. It's been a while, sir.
Very good, Mr. Will. Hey, Jim.
Last time I saw you, it was about 3 o'clock. I'm on the news. So I'm in, and I'm going. That was a joke.
Hey, I'm not making that, dude.
You what?
Yeah, I'm making that.
No, I'll make Thursday night. Gotta see the council meeting that though.
Yeah. 7:06.
Hey, Nadia.
Hello, Commissioner Mingus.
Get a good one.
Hey, did you still old mess, big old mess?
Oh, yeah. Man, I watched all that game.
I thought about you and that player to get in on, but you forget it, right?
They, I couldn't, 3 seconds left. I set up a hole, but you lost that game last week.
Johnny football, got you, didn't you? You know what I mean?
He is.
Huh?
We had a 4th and 6, 4th and 8, I forget what. I thought we had a stop.
Yeah.
About 12 yards left to middle. Set up half the night, watch football game, we lose. It's just tough. It's a great game, but we've had a 41-30 game. You what?
That's a close game.
It was. We lost with 3 seconds. We tied up, and then we kicked off, and they drove down to like a minute and a half left, but they just kicked field with a point.
Hey, something.
Oh.
I've never seen a play that partially looks like unreal.
Right. He is. One time he just stopped and jumped that way and took off again. I mean, you can't tackle
him. Is he big? He doesn't look like he's that big.
No, he's not that big.
Okay.
But he can go to football.
Oh, and he's quick enough.
So,
will he be able to make it to the next level?
He reminds you a whole lot of that blue. But
yeah. When he gets out, he was problem was he wasn't home much playing in the NFL either. Yeah. I mean, he had a good arm and he was pretty quick. But when those linemen, 6'4" to 6'6", or even taller, that are offensive linemen and the defensive linemen are that tall or taller.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard for a guy that's about 5'8"
yeah,
to make passes.
How actually tall is he? But he's not 6 foot. I think he's 6 foot.
I don't know. That's why I was asking. You know, about half the time you can't believe what they say. You know, they call his stats.
He's
a player, a deep player.
Let me not say important.
He just gonna make it
go. On the run, but anybody I've seen, just take off from left to right. He's slinging along downfield for 30, 40 yards. He's a wonderful player to watch.
Yeah. You know, that's why somebody like Cam Newton is so successful. He can run and throw the ball on the run, but he's big as tall, so he can drop back
down. Now, Missouri should be shocked with people on Saturday. I thought Georgia pounded Missouri.
I did.
You did?
I just had this bad feeling. Four of skilled players on offense. Our defense hasn't stopped anybody all season. Look how we did against Tennessee. And then look how Oregon, which is top 10 team and top 5 team, did against Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's a lot of no comparison. I was going to be cool to oil this instead of just going to get a tough game.
Yeah,
it was.
Yeah. I thought we could Missouri better. I thought we were.
Yeah.
How did you do?
Move
the clock right, or we need to wait?
It says 5 o'clock, is right.
I got five. AT&T says five. Says five. Five, you good yet?
Yep.
All right, it's 5 o'clock. I'll call it October 15, 2013, city of Cumberland planning zoning meeting to order. Item number two, I have a motion to adopt the agenda.
So moved.
Second.
Carried unanimously. Item number three, I have a motion to approve the September 17, 2013 meeting.
Motion.
Second.
Second by Bubba. Carried unanimously. Item number four, any old business, Scott?
No, sir.
Yeah. Item number five, new business, Sony Valley LP rezoning request number 2013245. If you will, somebody, we're going to open a public hearing. Each side has 10 minutes. You don't use your 10 minutes to leave your vote, to answer some questions, then you can come back and use that amount of time. But I have a motion to open a public hearing on rezoning request number 2013245.
Motion open hearing.
Second.
Public hearing, I vote. Public hearing open. Somebody will come, Catherine, Lee, come on, come up and tell us what you got.
I'm gonna speak yesterday.
Good evening, gentlemen and commissioners. We have 6 acres, 6.5 acres that we would like to have zoned to residential for R1 residential complex homes there. It's at the corner of Brooks Farm and Highway 9 on the Long Road. It's owned by Sony Valley LP, and we're going to have individual driveways and each. There are three lots that we're asking to be rezoned from Oklahoma. It's three individual lots with an individual driveway for each one.
Mr. Chairman, I've got a couple of questions.
Sure.
The same as while she's there, if I could. Okay. Number one, as I'm sure you're aware, we've gotten some objection correspondence, emails, and letters from your family members, two of them objecting to this. There have been some references in there to a trust as opposed to Sony Valley LP. There's another document that says it's owned by Sony Valley Farms LP. And there's a third document that says it's owned by Marital Trust Sony Valley LP. And so the city just needs to know who the proper legal entity is, so then when we're doing the rezoning, we're using the proper legal name, because there are different names floating around there. And there's an implication, as Martha is aware from a legal perspective, it's a trust versus a limited partnership. We don't know, it's not our business, it's your family business. What we need to know as a city is what is the legal entity that owns the property. So that's sort of issue one. Issue two is the plat that you have submitted shows 6 different tracts.
Yes.
And we don't have that in the city. The city's records and the county tax records show it as one plat for one piece of property. And of course, legally, the city can't partially rezone an undivided tract. You have to subdivide the tract, which all that means is you submit this plat for approval. The county and city would vote, in this case, the city would approve it before the county could report it. Once you have a reported plat of subdivided property, you can apply to rezone a portion of it. You can't rezone half of a 13-acre tract unless you have a reported plat that authorizes that subdivision. You don't have that right now. So
okay.
It can be heard by this group,
okay.
But the city council can't vote on it next month until that is done. So I'm trying to tell you what has to happen.
All right. Before okay.
It gets to the next
we weren't aware.
I understand that. That's the whole purpose of me speaking at this point. I wanted to make you aware
sure.
of that requirement.
And we can do that.
So we need to have a reported plat that is approved by the city, and then once Scott's office approves it, the county clerk will record it, and once we have it recorded at flat book 123, page 456, and we can take action on less than the whole trial.
Okay.
And the second thing is, we need to make sure that we have the proper legal title before we own. We've got different things, and if it's...
I believe we applied for the zoning in the property.
In Sunny Valley, okay.
Sunny Valley, okay.
Okay, so the other names that are contained both in some of the objection letters, as well as in, like, this plat's got two different names on it, for example. It also lists the owner as Marital Trust, Sunny Valley, okay.
That's not...
Which is a different legal entity.
That's not, that's not, that's Marital Trust, Sunny Valley.
I'm not trying to be hard to get, I just want to make sure.
But I think the documents that we submitted were in the name of Sunny Valley, and that is the...
That is who the...
That is the owner of the property.
Well, that's the other issue.
Thank you, Mr. Miles. We'll look at that plat, apply for, and make sure that that's done before.
Before November 19th, just before the council.
Will it even come before this board again?
No.
Okay, we can do the zoning hearing on this, even though it's...
Yes.
We don't have to go there, okay.
The planning commission is not aware of what I just asked you.
Oh, okay.
When I looked at that was the legal issue that I saw that I needed to bring to their attention at this time, which need for y'all to get straight before it goes to the next level. Doesn't stop this hearing from moving forward.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for allowing me.
Thank you. Any other questions for the board? Thank you. We have anyone here who wants to speak in opposition? Okay. Close the hearing. I have motion to close the hearing.
Motion to close the hearing.
One second, I vote. It's unanimous. Scott, you have a recommendation for the staff?
Yes, sir. We'll address the staff report and back up to review the record. Departments of the Sunny Valley LP, the property owner, made application to rezone a portion of 13.059 acres from office professional to single-family residential while proposing subdividing the property into six buildable tracts. Specifically, the owners have requested tracts 1 through 3, located closest to the block of Highway State Route 9, be rezoned to R1, while tracts 4.4 through 6 remain zoned office professional. To the best of our knowledge, the rezoning of this property would not be a detriment to the case of the property owners' value and use enjoyment of their properties. This rezoning is in conformance with the city's future land use plan, which shows the property as residential mixed use. The staff recommends approving the rezoning with the following conditions. The rezoning of tracts 1 through 3 to R1 will be done in accordance with meets and bounds legal descriptions submitted as part of the application package. And condition number 2, the property owner will dedicate the property to the city and construct a 4-foot wide sidewalk along the entire frontage of Brooks Farm Drive, which the city will maintain. That's the only two conditions that the staff has. We do recommend approval of those conditions.
Mr. Chairman, I would add, and I think this will be taken care of, but they'll have to have, is another condition that should probably be added from the staff perspective, that they have a properly recorded plat showing the subdivision of the different tracts. Because right now, the city's record, the county's record, that's one thing in the track.
But okay, I'll listen for change of just part of it. Within the package, there is a meets and bounds speech loss for revenue 1, 2, 3. For this, just in that,
that's correct. We are
identified by those meets.
That's great. That's our reference.
And I'm confident that it's all the issue that I brought up before it gets to the city council. I just want to make sure that that's
well, we're identified by those meets and bounds. As long as we report that, it makes those meets and bounds.
That's correct.
Can I ask a question, please?
Sure.
Whose responsibility will it be to install the sidewalk?
It'll be the owner's responsibility.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, anything?
With that sidewalk, can we put it the issue is there's this beautiful tree that's right on the side of the road and in the road, in the right. Well, that would be where that sidewalk would go. Is there anything to say that we could move the sidewalk around that tree just so we don't have to take out the tree? Onto our property.
Possibly maybe with these, but I can't answer that, but that's not necessarily an answer for us, as much as that is the permit process.
Okay.
Permit or whatever, that's where they would.
That's where you would address that issue.
I'm not sure whether we can address that with these or not, that would come to a question. That's not the zoning.
Okay.
I mean, we have to change, you have to do some sidewalk by, if you're changing from that, that would be a administrative barrier or something like that, but we don't think. Okay.
Other questions from the board?
I make a motion that we send the rezone request number 2013245 to council for approval with staff, two staff recommendations and a third condition that says plat must be recorded and identified with the county before the council meeting. How does that?
Second.
Motion second, everybody voting. Motion carried unanimously. Thank you. Item number six, any announcements?
No, sir. Do you have any, Jeff?
Yeah. Item number seven, I have motion with Jerry.
Motion with Jerry.
Second.
Motion second, everybody voting. Carried unanimously. Thanks.
Thank you.
See ya.
See ya.